Welcome to House Church at the Rectory of the Church of the Holy Spirit. Today is Good Friday. We've got a long lineup for you today. We have our Good Friday service at noon here from the Rectory with Reverend Jihan. We have a children's Good Friday service available on our website. We have a re-presentation of the St. John's Passion by our Senior Choir and St. Gregory's Choir, available by podcast on our website. And we have Stations of the Cross, also available on our website in a very attractive leaflet with images of the cross, or you may use a cross from your own home, in your own home. And finally, remember, on this day, on Good Friday, all offerings go to the church's mission and ministry in the Holy Land. And more information about all of this Good Friday lineup at www.chslf.org. Thank you.
Blessed be our God,
forever and ever.
Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now, sisters and brothers, let us pray together Psalm 40, verses 1 through 14, which can be found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 640. Verses 1 through 14.
I waited patiently upon the Lord. He stooped to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of the desolate pit, out of the mire and clay. He set my feet upon a high cliff and made my footing sure. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. And they shall see and stand in awe and put their trust in the Lord. Happy are they who trust in the Lord. They do not resort to evil spirits or turn to false gods. Great things are they that you have done, O Lord my God. How great your wonders and your plans for us. There is none who can compare to you. Oh, that I could make them known and tell them, but they are more than I can count. In sacrifice and offering you take no pleasure. You have given me ears to hear you. Burnt offerings and sin offering you have not required. And so I said, behold, I come. In the roll of the book it is written concerning me. I do to do your will, O my God. Your law is deep in my heart. I proclaim righteousness in the great congregation. Behold, I did not restrain my lips. And that, O Lord, you know. Your righteousness have I not hidden in my heart. I have spoken of your faithfulness and your deliverance. I have not concealed your love and faithfulness from the great congregation. You are the Lord. Do not withhold your compassion from me. Let your love and your faithfulness keep me safe forever. For innumerable troubles have crowded upon me. My sins have overtaken me, and I cannot see. They are more in number than the hairs of my head, and my heart fails me. Be pleased, O Lord, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. And the soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and striking him on the face. Pilate went out again and said to them, "Look, I am bringing him out to let you know that I have found no case against him." So Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. Pilate said to them, "Here is the man." When the chief priest and the police saw him, they shouted, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no case against him." The Jews answered him, "We have a law, and according to that law, he ought to die because he has claimed to be the Son of God." Now, when Pilate heard this, he was more afraid than ever. He entered his headquarters again and asked Jesus, "Where are you from?" But Jesus gave him no answer. He entered into the headquarters again and asked, "Where are you from?" But Jesus again gave him no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, "Do you refuse to speak to me? Do you not know that I have the power to release you and the power to crucify you?" Jesus answered him, "You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore, the one who handed me over to you is guilty of a greater sin." From then on, Pilate tried to release him, but the Jews cried out, "If you release this man, you are no friend of the emperor. Everyone who claims to be king sets himself against the emperor." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus outside and sat on the judge's bench at a place called the Stone Pavement, or in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover, and it was about noon. He said to the Jews, "Here is your king." They cried out, "Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!" Pilate asked them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king but the emperor." Then he handed him over to them to be crucified. So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross by himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, which in Hebrew is called Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews." Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written."
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them in four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven of one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it, to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots." And this is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. After this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scriptures, "I am thirsty."
A jar full of sour wine was standing there, so they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. Since it was the day of preparation, the Jews did not want the bodies to be left on the cross during the Sabbath, especially because that Sabbath was a day of great solemnity. So they asked Pilate to have the legs of the crucified men broken and the bodies removed. Then the soldiers came and they broke the legs of the first and of the other who had been crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. Instead, one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once blood and water came out. He who saw this testified, so that we may also believe. His testimony is true, and he knows that he tells the truth. These things occurred so that the scriptures might be fulfilled. None of his bones shall be broken. And again, another passage of scripture says, they will look upon the one whom they have pierced.
Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness. As many of you know, I am studying. I'm taking some classes at Bexley Seabury. And just this past week, we've been doing a lot of reading in my systematic theology course on the cross. And I thought this is so appropriate, considering that this is now Holy Week. And in one of the readings, there was a chapter called The Godlessness of the Cross. The Godlessness of the Cross. And the author penned these words: "Who could have known that the way through the wilderness to redemption would be a path of humiliation trodden by the Spirit of God? Who knew that the content of sing to the Lord a new song would be before a man condemned?" The last thing, the author writes, the last thing that anyone could have ever imagined was a crucified Son of God. On this day, on Good Friday, you and I remember this horrible, horrific hour. This hour was graphic, bloody, scandalous, and for the Jews of the time who were followers of our Lord, this was indeed embarrassing, absolutely embarrassing. And the day that we remember that our Lord and Savior died on the hardwood of a cross. On this Good Friday, people today throughout the entire globe, I'm sure, have either prayed these words silently or aloud: my God, why have you forsaken me? Where are you? I am sick. I am lonely. I feel isolated. I haven't seen my family in weeks, in months. How could you allow something like this to happen? However you feel in this moment, in the days and the weeks to come, the Holy Bible teaches us that we serve and follow a Lord who is acquainted with grief and one who knows all of our sorrows. Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters, died on Good Friday so that we might live. Jesus died that we may be set free from all sin. Jesus died so that you and I may be forgiven, and with his stripes, you and I and the entire world will be healed. Jesus died to reconcile us to himself, and that is the good news. That is a message of love. When I was a small girl, I remember learning a song. Mr. D
as I called him, was the gentleman over our music program at our church. And we would sing this song during Holy Week, and I would love to share it with you. When Jesus died on Calvary to save a wretch like you and me, that's love, that's love. They hung him high, they stretched him wide, he hung his head, and then he died. That's love, that's love. But that's not how the story ends, 'cause 3 days later he rose again. That's love, that's love. That is love. That is love, brothers and sisters, that we serve a risen Savior. That Good Friday is not the end of this passion story, that we will again celebrate on the third day. You and I will be back together in our wonderful church. We will see our loved ones again because Jesus rose. Good Friday is not the end of this story. And we have faith and confidence in knowing that Jesus Christ died for you and me, not out of fear, not out of guilt, but purely out of love. So live into that fullness and that understanding that God absolutely loves you. Amen.
Amen. Lift every voice and sing hymn 91, Give Me Jesus.
In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You may have all this world, give me Jesus. Dark midnight was my cry, dark midnight was my cry, dark midnight was my cry, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You may have all this world, give me Jesus. Oh, when I come to die, oh, when I come to die, oh, when I come to die, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You may have all this world, give me Jesus. Dear people of God, our Heavenly Father sent His Son into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved, that all people who believe in Him might be delivered from the power of sin and death and become heirs with Him of everlasting life. We pray, therefore, for people everywhere according to their need. Let us pray for the Holy Catholic Church of Christ throughout the world, that God will confirm His church in faith, increase it in love, and preserve it in peace.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church,
that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Let us pray for all nations and peoples of the earth, and for those in authority among them, that by God's help they may seek justice and truth and live in peace and concord.
Almighty God, kindle, we pray, in every heart the true love of peace, and guide with your wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your dominion may increase until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for all of those who suffer and are afflicted in body or in mind, that God in his mercy will comfort and relieve them and grant them the knowledge of his love and stir up in us the will and patience to minister to their needs.
Gracious God, the comfort of all who sorrow, the strength of all who suffer, especially those suffering from COVID-19. Let the cry of those in misery and need come to you, that they may find your mercy present with them in all their sickness, in their shortness of breath, and their afflictions. And give us, we pray, the strength to serve them for the sake of him who suffered for us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for all who have not yet received the gospel of Christ, that God will open their hearts to the truth and lead them to faith and obedience.
Merciful God, creator of all the peoples of the earth and lover of every soul, have compassion on all who do not know you as you are revealed in your Son, Jesus Christ. Let your gospel be preached with grace and power and song and love. To those who have not heard it, turn the hearts of those who resist it, and bring home to your fold those who have gone astray, that there may be one flock under one shepherd, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us commit ourselves to our God and pray for the grace of a holy life, that with all who have departed this world and have died in the peace of Christ, and those whose faith is known to God alone, we may be accounted worthy to enter into the fullness of the joy of our Lord and receive the crown of life in the day of resurrection.
O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and all things are being brought to their perfection. By him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. We glory in your cross, O Lord.
And praise and glorify your holy resurrection, for by virtue of your cross, joy has come to the whole world.
May God be merciful to us and bless us. Show us the light of his countenance and come to us.
Let your ways be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
We glory in your cross, O Lord. And praise and glorify your holy resurrection, for by virtue of your cross, joy has come to the whole world.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endure, we shall also reign with him.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
O Savior of the world, who by the cross and precious blood hast redeemed us, save us and help us. We humbly beseech thee, O Lord.
And now we have our own special musical offering from the musicians at the Church of the Holy Spirit.
It's time for us to move into the Holy Communion from the reserved sacrament. Mm-hmm. This is the point on Good Friday when the remaining sacrament that's been in our ombre at the Church of the Holy Spirit, and then we brought it over to the rectory, and it's been accompanied by the presence of the sanctuary lamp that symbolizes the light of Christ, just like you were talking about with our children's service earlier. Mm-hmm. So what we do now is we confess our sins, we say the Lord's Prayer. Reverend Jihan and I will consume the remaining reserved sacrament, mm-hmm. and we will extinguish the candlelight.
Yes. Let us now confess our sins unto Almighty God.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name.
Amen.
The peace of God, which passes understanding, may it bless you, forgive you, pardon you from all your sins, and confirm you in the goodness, the love, and the forgiveness of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. And now let us pray in the words that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ hath taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Good Friday observance continues now with an invitation to everyone to visit our website, www.chslf.org, and there you will find a link to the St. John's Passion by Bach that the Senior Choir, St. Gregory's Choir, at the Church of the Holy Spirit, and many of our friends and musicians provided for us last year, mm-hmm. in 2019. On our website, you can link to that podcast and enjoy the entirety of that amazing recording. Such a heartfelt offering from the musicians at Holy Spirit, such a blessing to this community. Music that emerges out of a tradition in Europe of recovery, surviving and recovering from the plague. And so when you listen to those great, great sounds, know that there's a unity of heart there that goes into deep time with our predecessors. We will also be offering on the website Stations of the Cross. You can go to the website and download the leaflet and observe the Stations of the Cross in your own home. Perhaps you've got a
your own cross you could take and hold as you do the stations. But the leaflet includes numerous images for you to pray with and to meditate upon. And Jihan, you want to say a word about the rest of the weekend?
And so Father Luke and I will be together at the Great Easter Vigil that Saturday evening. And then, of course, we will have a glorious Easter Sunday resurrection service for all of us to participate in.
So we'll see you down the line.
Yes, we will.
All right. Blessings to you.
God bless you.